Hello, this is my mini lesson on music during World War II. On July 22, 1940, the Special Services was established as an entertainment branch of the USA War Department. Both military troops and local performers would be included in the creation of many plays, songs, documentaries, and more in order to both entertain the citizens of America and create pro-America propaganda. Most of his early projects were about World War II, which is quite obvious in his creation date. Also in 1940, the song What's Your Number? / Draft and Blues would be released. It is a purely instrumental track, and it should be playing in the background right now. While the music may not have much to do with the ongoing war, the title definitely does. The term number in the title refers to a soldier's service number, a system that was created in World War I and ended its use in 1969. It was needed to keep track of the soldiers, especially when they died and their body was unidentifiable via looks. Beginning the year of 1941, Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy talks of a bugle player drafted into the war. During his time, he was sad about the way the army made him play the bugle, which was most likely fanfare or stuff like that. Luckily, his captain saw this and instated a band for him to play his style of music in. This song was most likely made to appeal to musicians and encourage them to join the army in order to not only support their country on the battlefield, but to also be able to meet other musicians and make music with them during their stay in the military. When he plays reveille, he's the boogie woogie bugle. Live at Minton's Playhouse was an event where many musicians played at. It doesn't have much to do with the war, but it did make strides in the music industry by helping birth a new genre of music called bebop. The song that's playing in the background right now is Swing to Bop by Charlie Christian.
We're in the army now, we're in the army now, we've a duty to do, we'll do it too, we're in the army now.
Ending 1941 and being the first song with video, He's 1A in the Army and A1 in My Heart is a song about a girl's boyfriend or husband being able to serve in the Army. The term 1A refers to a person being available for military service, with many other classifications existing with similar terminology. A1 in the Heart most likely just refers to how much love the woman has for the man going into the Army. This song was most likely created to help ease the pain of seeing a loved one begin serving in the military, as it is never an easy goodbye. 1942 now, and the first song on the list is This Is the Army, Mr. Jones, from the musical This Is the Army. You can go and watch that for free on YouTube if you'd like, but we are focusing on this specific song from it. This Is the Army, Mr. Jones opens with a line of bugles introducing the song, and quickly switches to a massive choir of soldiers singing about the US Army being the greatest army in the world. Later on, a ragtag group of very different men lines up and sings about being drafted. After their part, they do a quick change into uniform while the choir repeats what they just sang. This was most likely created to signify that the US Army can change even the poorest bums into stately men of respectable stature. I am now running out of time to write the script, so we'll do a quick fire round for the next couple of years. The rest of 1942 consisted of Praise the Lord and Pass the Ammunition and Slap the Dirty Little Jap. The first was most likely inspired by a soldier on the battlefield saying something similar to the title, and the second song was made after the bombing of Pearl Harbor as anti-Japan propaganda. 1943 has four songs on this list, but we'll get to the first one later, as it has a pretty long explanation. The other three are Rosie the Riveter, Stalin Wasn't Stalin, and Johnny Zero. Rosie the Riveter encouraged women to work in factories, especially as a riveter. Stalin Wasn't Stalin praised Stalin's efforts against Hitler and the Nazis, and Johnny Zero sings of a boy who didn't do so well in school, but was also one of the best pilots the US Army had, taking down multiple enemy planes, especially the Mitsubishi AM-60. 1944 had a theme in the songs for this list, with both speaking of a person waiting for their spouse to return from the war. Till Then was from the perspective of a husband telling his wife to wait for him, and There's a Fellow Waiting in Poughkeepsie speaks of a man waiting for his wife to return from her service. 1945 only had one song on this list, and its title is Roger Young. It speaks of a private named Roger Young, that won a posthumous Medal of Honor while being deaf. The writer of the song decided to do it about him in particular because he wanted to write a song about a winner of the medal, but the other winners of the medal had two foreign-sounding names. He finally settled on Roger Young because it was a good American-sounding name. Going back to 1943, one song stands above the rest for how iconic it was. Der Führer's Face was a song written to mock how the Nazis honored their ruler. It was used in a Donald Duck cartoon where Donald was having a nightmare about being a citizen of Nazi Germany. It had many exaggerations of the hardships of the failing country, but still helped motivate people to be proud of their nationality. In the nightmare, Donald had to wake up early, hide his coffee supply, eat bread-shaped wood, and go to work at a factory with a repetitive job of screwing on the top of shelves, all while having to salute and say the infamous two words whenever seeing a picture of Hitler or having the salute and catchphrase said to or near him. He eventually goes crazy and starts having hallucinations that compare the Nazis to the shells he was making in its own twisted way. He eventually wakes up and almost thinks that he is still in Germany, but realizes that the shadow on his wall is just an unfortunate twisting of his miniature Statue of Liberty. The cartoon ends with him hugging and giving a big kiss to the mini statue while proclaiming his pride of being a citizen of the United States of America. After the war, there were many songs about the war or about things that came out of the war, like atomic bombs, but I don't have time to get into them today. Hope you enjoyed!